आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सिलेबस. इन नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सिलेबस ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स वी हैव चैप्टर 4 दैट इज प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री. नाउ वी स्टार्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री. नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू इन द ज्योमेट्री व्हाट वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ शेप्स वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट. As we have already done chapter 3 that is understanding quadrilaterals in which we already studied about the quadrilaterals. In practical geometry we construct all such kind of quadrilaterals. You know very well. Let us start with the definition which kind of figures or which kind of diagram we have to construct in this chapter. Definition: quadrilateral is a polygon with four sides or edges. You know very well what is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is a four-sided figure, or we can say is a polygon with four-sided or edges and four vertex. These two parts of the quadrilaterals are important. That is four sides and four vertex. All right, vertex or we can say corners. A quadrilateral has 10 parts in all. Total in quadrilateral we have 10 parts. Understand those parts. First is four sides, four angles and two diagonals which are used to construct a quadrilateral. To construct a quadrilateral we need to know about any five parts. Out of these 10 parts, we have 10 parts of the quadrilateral. You know very well, four sides, four angles and two diagonals. Out of these 10 parts, we must have five parts in all given to construct a quadrilateral using the geometry. All right. Now, in this quadrilateral, as you can see, A, B, C, D is a four-sided polygon, is a quadrilateral in which A, B, B, C, C, D and D, A are four sides. Similarly, angle A, angle B, this is angle C and this is we can name as angle D. Four angles and two diagonal. Diagonal A, C. Diagonal is made by the line segment made by the opposite vertex or the corners. Alright. These are adjacent corner and these are opposite corner or the vertex. So these are the sides and these are the diagonal. Diagonal A, C and diagonal B, D. Now A, B and D, C are opposite sides but A, D and D, C are the adjacent sides. So in quadrilateral we have two adjacent sides in all, A, B and D, C. Similarly other two are B, C and C, D and so on. So four sides, four angles and two diagonals. Total how many parts we have? 10 parts. But to construct a quadrilateral using the geometry, equipments that is a pencil and a scale and a compass, eraser, everything with you. Tomorrow we start with the construction. Today we do just go through the introduction. What is a practical geometry actually? In this chapter, what we have to study about? We will study the following concept. First, construction of quadrilateral. We have to construct, we have to draw the quadrilateral. If the length of four sides, the length means AB length is given, AD length is given, DC length is given, CB length is given and BA length is given. These sides may be equal because in quadrilateral we have square in which all sides are equal, rectangle in which opposite sides are equal. Similarly we have kite, we have trapezium or we can draw rhombus, all are under quadrilateral. Kite is also in which as the adjacent sides are equal. So the basic conditions, which conditions we must know to construct the quadrilateral, these four conditions, any one condition is given, we can construct quadrilateral. So first condition, construct a quadrilateral if length of four sides and a diagonal is given. That is length of four sides, four things and one diagonal. So we have five parts are given, length of four sides and any one diagonal is given. This is the first condition. If this condition satisfied, we can construct a quadrilateral. Similarly, if this condition is not satisfied and second condition is satisfied, then we can also construct a quadrilateral. What is the condition? Construct a quadrilateral if its two diagonals A, C, B, D, we can name by another alphabet diagonals, we can name them differently. So two diagonals and three sides are given. So at least three sides, the length of three sides must be known to us, any three sides and two diagonals. Now next, third condition is, you understand first and second condition? Third is construction of quadrilateral if two adjacent sides means side AD, DC or side AB, BC. These are adjacent sides. So any two adjacent sides like 1 and 2, these are two sides. Alright, like two adjacent sides and three angles, any three angles are given. If this condition is given, then we can construct a quadrilateral. Next, the fourth condition is construction of quadrilateral if its three sides and two included angles are given. If sides, only three sides are given and no diagonal are given, but two included means the angle made by these sides are given, then we can construct a quadrilateral. So by using these conditions, we can construct a quadrilateral using the geometrical parts. Now I thought you understand the meaning of practical geometry. We have to construct a quadrilateral, a four-sided figure, 10 parts of these four-sided figure, you understand. Any five parts are given, these are the conditions. By using these conditions, we can construct a quadrilateral. Now students, I also sent a link to you so that you get more introduction of the practical geometry. Tomorrow all of you must ready with your practical geometry, geometry instruments or compass and your scale, pencil, eraser, everything, so that we can construct some quadrilateral.